having reported on the royals for more than 10 years, I've heard some extraordinary things. But the information I was given at the end of last week left me startled. Meghan and Harry, I was told, are considering raising their child gender-neutral, understood to mean they will not enforce any male or female stereotypes. The exact phrase the Duchess apparently used, that they plan to take a fluid approach to child-rearing, initially sounded so odd that I wondered if it could possibly be true. According to the source, who has known the Duchess for many years and was at her wedding, Meghan has been talking to some of her friends about the birth and how she and Harry plan to raise their baby. She said they plan to raise their child with a fluid approach to gender and they won't be imposing any stereotypes. So what will this actually mean? By far the most likely scenario is that the couple could choose to forego traditional blues and pinks to match the baby's gender. They could also avoid conventional gender bias toys such as dolls for girls and train sets for boys. The story, first reported in the Mail on Sunday last weekend and later in Vanity Fair, was picked up around the world. Significantly, last night a senior Kensington Palace aide refused to rule out the possibility of the baby being raised gender neutral. This could be yet another sign that the Duchess is determined to shake up the way that young royals are raised. Take the couple's new home, Frogmore Cottage in Windsor, for instance. The couple are currently renovating it, and are understood to have chosen neutral grey and white hues for the nursery, rather than the blue or pink. Meghan is, of course, already known for being her own person at the palace. She is a 37-year-old woman who had a career before coming here. She'll have ideas and influences over things, says a close source. The Sussexes claim publicly that they do not know the sex of their baby. But in private, Meghan is understood to have told friends who attended her recent baby shower that the child is a boy. Whatever the gender, those close to the couple insist they will be open-minded and liberal parents. There has been a recent trend for celebrity parents, such as British singer Paloma Faith and Hollywood actress Kate Hudson, to raise their children as completely gender-neutral, in other words, as neither girls nor boys, an approach which allows, apparently, the freedom for the youngsters to define themselves as they see fit. But it's doubtful the royal couple will take it to such an extreme. So don't expect to see a prince in a tutu, or hear news that they're abandoning he and she pronouns altogether. They'll have the baby and then decide how to raise it, one source said. If they choose to go down a gender-neutral route, then there will be a balance. If it is a boy, they will dress him like a boy, and if it's a girl, they will dress her like a girl. But what they won't be keen on is forcing their child to conform to other gender stereotypes. The Cambridges have also taken a modern view of parenting, although not to this extent. Prince George was educated at a Montessori and attends a co-educational school in Battersea, South London. William and Kate do the school run and the children enjoy relatively normal lives. Yet they are still traditional in some crucial respects. They have a Norland-trained nanny, Princess Charlotte is rarely seen out of a dress, and Prince George was even spotted playing with a toy gun last summer. How far the Sussexes plan to take their fluid approach does, of course, remain to be seen. Meghan has transformed her husband in many ways. Harry has given up alcohol in solidarity with his pregnant wife, quit smoking and recently revealed he starts the day by meditating. But the Duke is still very much a traditionalist at heart. He has continued his passion for hunting and shooting despite Meghan's love for animals. And as a young boy, he was always running around Highgrove in military fatigues, climbing trees and playing toy soldiers with Prince William. Meghan has also revealed she played with dolls as a child. A spokesman for Kensington Palace last night said, "The Duke and Duchess are extremely excited to welcome their first child in the spring."